as love is fading from all the things that we are but are not saying. Can we see beyond the scars and make it to the dawn? Change the colors of the sky and open up to
to Radio Walford, and that was Westlife for you there. Now, a new part of our page is when we post up about a certain storyline or a certain character, and we have to discuss about them. So, for this episode, we wanted to know what you thought about Kirsty Branning. Should she have told Max the truth in the first place about the baby lies? Will she go back to Carl? Or will Max and Kirsty rekindle their relationship? So we asked you to tell us, and we have got so many comments to tell you and get through that, please forgive me if you get bored, but we do have shoutouts after this, and you might be the one being mentioned, so stay tuned. So here is what people have said about our certain topic this week. So we've got a few comments, some are nasty, but I'm not going to read them out. Rebecca and Gardiner says, I am glad they are not together, I don't like them anyway, I love Carl. Kelly Gibson says she should have told Max she wasn't pregnant. She shouldn't have lied. That is why Max left her in the first place. Patricia Julie Winslow Lennon says there is no chemistry between the two actors at all, so it doesn't work for me at all. I don't like her character. Jean Mayer says, of course, Kirsty should never have lied about such a thing. I think she'll go back to Carl, but that is a big mistake. But her and Max are not suited. Stacey Victoria Eggleston says, I think that Kirsty should have told Max and they will get back together, most likely with Kirsty's jealousy and lies. Chris Landers says, Kirsty should never get back with Carl, it gives Max a bit of peace. And Abby Swinley says she will look after her dad. Kirsty breaks families up and is a liar, somebody Max doesn't really want. Marilyn says, lie or no lie, she should go. She does not fit in. Her days should be numbered. Max should be concentrating on making sure that sweet Abby is alright with her mum. Sister and brother are going away. She needs to be made to feel important, as she has been too long in the shadow of Lauren. So Max should put his own needs to one side for his beautiful daughter. Then Tanya will perhaps take Max more seriously when he is telling her that he wants to be a family again. Okay, so there's a few comments. Megan Perkins says, I'm glad they are not together anymore. I want her to go back to go, and Max and Tanya to go back out, and Lauren to get back, and her and Joey go back out. I want the old Lauren back. She was better. Get rid of Lucy. She just twisted. Hee hee. There's a few things there that won't be happening. Sorry, Megan. Julia Cargill says, Max lied to Tanya loads of times. So for me, Max and Kirsty are as bad as each other. Perfect pair. And Penelope Jane Hill says she's a liar. I hope they don't get back together. So thank you for your comments. They are amazing. And I agree with a certain few of them. So thank you very much. And if you want to be part of next week's show, where I'll be reading out your comments, we've got another discussion coming up when the show has aired, which is talking about Ronnie when she returns to the square and what you think will happen, what you think should happen. Should she leave with Jack? Will Ronnie be in trouble for Kat and Alfie? Will it lead to Kat and Alfie getting back together, because obviously Roxy is her sister? There's lots to talk about Ronnie, and that discussion will be up very shortly, and your comments, if you write on them, should be up on the next show, so thank you very much. So a few shout-outs now on Radio Walford. So we have plenty of shout-outs to get through today. The first shout-out go to all the Brummies from Birmingham. They are Colette, to Dave, to Nathan, to Chloe, and to Emma. And I hope Chloe's well, Colette. And I hope you enjoyed Westlife, which I played especially for you. A shout-out to especially Nathan, because he's a great friend, and I hope you are enjoying the show, and thank you for listening, and I'll see you all very soon. A shout-out to Mickey Wildman for his help a few weeks ago and for his continuous help now. A shout-out to Stephen Legg, thank you for your help and to get people to listen, and of course, thank you for listening yourself. A shout out to, I've got hay fever, folks, you'll have to excuse me. A shout out to Dan Smith. Thank you for a great year at college and hope to see you very soon. And it's going to be weird not seeing you a lot next year. Thank you for listening to the show. A shout out to all my family and thank you for listening and thank you for supporting me and making me want to do it even more. And of course, a shout out to, and he always gets a shout out, so a shout out to Chris, who I didn't shout out to last time because I just completely forgot, and I always ask you if you want a shout out, please send them in, because I won't shout you out if you don't. But this week I thought I'd let you off and, you know, let it be different. So a shout out to Chris, thank you for being such a brilliant mate and a brilliant brother. I'll call you a brother as well. Oh, of course, Nathan, another brother. He's my Doctor Who brother. And Star Wars. I'll say Star Wars because I'll be Darth Vader and you can be Luke Skywalker, someone like that. I'm really going off track here, aren't I? A shout out now to my EastEnders page admins for your continuous help and your continuous work. You are both brilliant. Thank you very, very much. And finally, to all my friends, a shout out to Darren for all your help with finding a different microphone your advice for finding a different microphone. A quick shout out now to Jason Turner, because your rap roundups are absolutely brilliant and amazing, and I'll continue to support you in future. And finally, a shout out to all my fans on my EastEnders page. I haven't got enough time to say hello to you all. And please join Kate Hibble-White's page. Just search Scott Maslen Fans on Facebook. I've got hay fever, you will have to excuse me. And of course, search David Witt. Or you can follow find his page at www.facebook.com/ultimate David Witts. and it's a brilliant page, and I'll continue to support you in the future. So that's as many shout-outs as I can give. Thank you very much to everyone. That is all we've got time for here today on Radio Walford, and I will see you all soon for episode 10, which will be another brilliantly action-packed episode. Thank you to everyone, and that's all we've got time for. See you next time on Radio Walford.